the South Sudan contingent of police, revenue collectors, and immigration and customs have held a meeting with their Ugandan counterparts at the Ugandan border post of Elego. This follows an uproar by the truck drivers against an alleged extortion and harassment for money by security officers while importing and exporting cargo through the roads in South Sudan.
About extortion, we have talked about these non-government officers who used to take money from beavers. So I wish there must be some changes.
In 2021, over 10 truck drivers are suspected to have been killed while transporting cargo into South Sudan. This has had a ripple effect on trade across the East African Community member states.
We hope that there must be changes, because they have told us that they are going to change where there is a need to change. They are going to change. So I'm calling them to start work.
Major General Gathon Joel Riek, the acting commissioner of customs under the South Sudan National Revenue Authority, led his countrymen as he confirmed that the government, under the leadership of President Salva Kiir, is committed to providing safety to all traders in the country.
It's not just sitting at ease. It has already taken precautions. It has already identified a good number of soldiers, or maybe from different departments of security, to come and go on the road, close down every illegal barrier.
While his Ugandan counterpart Abel Kagumire urges the government of South Sudan to strengthen its security along the border in order to fast track the economic development of the East African Community.
Finish 2 days, 3 days without movement. First of all, the people in South Sudan don't get supplies, especially perishables. So we want to work with them on seeing how we can create synergies and exchange information using the system. So the automation agenda is high level. And the other resolution is how we can use the single customs territory, because we are all members of the East African Community.
The office of the president at Elego border has welcomed the visit of the South Sudan officials, as both countries look forward to boosting economic growth within the East African Community.
The duty as an RDC is to coordinate, to ensure that the different government apparatuses work together.
The Uganda security leaders, including the Amuru Resident District Commissioner Odong Stephen Latek, the Police Regional Commander Damali Nachuha, have also pledged to contain future strikes.
As chairman of the District Security Committee, my duty is to ensure that every action does not have a negative bearing on security. We need to appreciate that the Ugandan administrative systems that supports the rule of law is fully operational. And as long as we put them all together and coordinate them well, all factors will work in the best interest of the citizens.
Immediately after gaining independence in 2011, South Sudan plunged into a civil war, displacing millions of its citizens. Around 1.4 million of them are refugees in Uganda. In this period, East African traders, teachers, NGO workers, including the Acholi Kekal Kwaro Cultural Institution, Prime Minister Ambrose Ola, and now truck drivers from all over the region, have been either murdered, injured, or kidnapped as they conduct their businesses. I am Joseph Omagoro, reporting for the news at Elego.